is to remember that the blessings of Allah don't cease at bad times.
Okay.
And I think that that is something that perhaps we forget.
Certainly.
Because we become very focused on the one thing that we want. You know, I really want to relief from my financial problems.
Right, for
and
example.
That becomes
my whole world.
You're everything.
Yeah.
And if Allah hasn't given you that relief, you feel as though He's given you nothing. But that's not true. Actually,
good
Allah
point.
Subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you many, many things. And you know, one of the ways you can see that is to look at those less fortunate than you.
Yeah.
Wherever you are, and it's something we say a lot in the West about, you know, bear in mind or look at those people who are less fortunate than you are.
Right, okay.
And actually, you know, it does have an Islamic point to it. You know,
okay.
When you see people who are less fortunate than you, it actually reminds you that Allah has given you an awful lot.
Yeah.
And even though your financial difficulty is tough, for example, it's nowhere near as bad as many, many people.
Right, okay.
And that's why some of the scholars of Islam used to say that when a calamity strikes me, I praise Allah that it's not a greater calamity.
Okay.
So the first thing I say Alhamdulillah for is Alhamdulillah, it isn't a greater calamity than it could have been far worse.
Right, okay.
You know? And some of them said Alhamdulillah that it's not in my religion.
SubhanAllah.
Because that would be the greater calamity.
Of course.
Imagine if you were tried with doubt in your religion,
yeah.
or atheism, or agnosticism. That's far, far worse.
Yeah.
Or some of the shubahat, the confusion and the doubts people put in your mind. That's far, far worse than being tried in your wealth, than
certainly.
Being tried with your children, loss of life,
this
loss of your poverty.
Yeah.
That's manageable, but loss of your religion, that's, you know, that's almost the stage where that's a true catastrophe.
Yeah.
So some of the scholars say, when I say Alhamdulillah in a bad time, I say Alhamdulillah, first of all, that it's not worse. And I say Alhamdulillah, that it's not in my religion.
Okay, wonderful point.
And I say Alhamdulillah because Allah Azza wa Jalla has guided me to praise Him